What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. I am pumped for today's mod. The newest addition to the 2020 Platinum just arrived a couple days ago. As you can see, it is a new grill, custom grill made by Royalty Core. I'll put the website up on your screen there so you guys can take a look. Their products are second to none, guys. This thing is built to last. It is a beast. It's got to go at least probably pushing 20 pounds, if not more. Solid steel, and the finish on it is just absolutely gorgeous. As you can see, it's got like a gloss black finish with the more of a satin finish to the mesh in between. Two different size mesh inserts on it, as you can see up there in the corner. I'll get up close so you can take a peek at it, and then you can view all these grills on their website as well. But this thing is just absolutely stunning, so I can't wait to get it put on the truck. I'm going to show you how to take the factory grill out of there, what we have to do to modify that to get this in its place, and I can't wait to see what this thing looks like. So let's get into it, and we'll get this party started. Okay, so for the first step, it's obviously taking the factory piece off of the truck. In order to do that, there's plenty of videos out there that show how to do this. It's very simple. I actually have a couple videos on my channel showing how to get the grill off, but it's very easy to do. All you need to do is remove two pop clips, one here and one on the other side, and then four 10 millimeter bolts. One here, two, three, four, and then here's the other pop clip that I mentioned. So once you remove those six, the four bolts and the two pop clips, the grill basically just lifts up over a little bit of a lip up here, and then you can just separate it from the truck. You just pull it towards you. Sometimes you got to give it a good yank towards you, especially if it's the first time or two that you've done it. So that's how you remove the grill. The only other thing is, if you do have an 18, 19, or 20, which this is a 20 Platinum, all you need to do, the other thing you need to do before you remove the grill, just remove this little panel and unclip the TSS safety system, which is right here. All right, so just go ahead and do that. I'm gonna separate, I'm not gonna show that on camera, very easy to do. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this grill assembly off, and I'll show you what we have to do next. So once you have the grill off of the truck, if you have an 18, 19, or 20 with the TSS Toyota safety system, all you're gonna wanna do is remove the sensor, which is this piece right here. It's only held on by three Phillips head screws. One right here, one here, and the silver one at the top. So you can remove those three screws and the sensor will come off. You'll be able to remove that from the grill. So once you have those three screws removed, the sensor itself is now free from the grill. You can do one of two things. You can either disconnect the wiring harness right here and just set the sensor aside, or what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna remove it altogether from the grill. So you just have to cut a couple zip ties that are holding the wiring harness to the grill, and then that way you can remove the harness with the sensor and just set it aside. We will talk about that more in more detail later in the video and what we're gonna do to get this to work with the new grill. All right, so now that we have the TSS safety system out of the way, as you can see, you're left with the grill surround and the grill insert. All right, so the next step is, and what I did off camera, it's kind of hard to get the angles. I very carefully set my new grill inside of here just to kind of see how it lined up and where exactly I have to cut. Because in order to get grills like this to work, you basically have to cut out this middle section of the mesh. And when you're doing this, just be very careful. Obviously, you know, measure 10 times, cut once kind of deal, because if you cut too much, you're SOL. So the way this is going to line up, I'll show you exactly where I cut, but you're basically, I'm going to take my angle grinder and I'm going to cut all the way around the edge, just leaving myself a little bit of a lip. And again, you can always cut more if you didn't cut enough. So it's always better to, you know, make your cuts, err on the side of caution with your first cut, and then line up the new grill, see how it fits. If you need to trim anything, then you can trim. So don't just go, you know, cutting away and end up cutting too much at first, because then you're SOL. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get that started. Again, I'm just gonna use my angle grinder going around the edge to basically remove this whole middle portion of mesh, because that's where the new grill is going to fit into. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. All right, so to just give you an idea of what you're left with, as you can see, not gonna lie, cutting into a 2020 Platinum grill. A little nerve-wracking, but if you follow my channel, you know that I'm not afraid to just start cutting. All right, so there's the piece that we cut out. Now, again, this was just my first initial cut. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to line the grill up on here so you can just kind of get an idea. I'll show you what I cut out so far. That's what I left up on top. I do think we have to trim this whole piece off, going all the way across the front. But again, before I go cutting anything else, I'm going to put the grill on top of here, see how it fits, see how it lines up, and then decide what else we need to trim. I do think this is the lip, this piece right here. I think we have to trim right up to this line. So I'm gonna go ahead and fit the grill, see how it lines up, and we'll go from there. All right, so after I lined the grill up to the shell, I did trim a little bit more. So let me just show you what we ended up with here. I have the grill secured to the outer shell of the truck, and I'll show you how we did that. I'll give you a look at how it fits all the way around as well. You do wanna leave, I don't know if you can see it, but this plastic right here, that's from my factory grill, the one that we cut out, and you want to leave that lip because the new grill sits up against there, and that's, it kind of sandwiches the new grill in there. So let me show you how you secure it. The new grill has these black brackets going all the way around it. You can see, I'm not sure how many exactly there is, I didn't count them, but you can see what I'm talking about. They're every so, you know, every so many inches. So what you do is they send you this type of hardware right here. You get screws, washers, and then these bent pieces. I'm not exactly sure what these are called, to be honest, but you can see you can actually screw into them. So what you're going to do is all of these black brackets have holes. So an extra set of hands comes in handy. My wife kind of helped me position the grill exactly where I wanted it. And then I used the 1/8 inch size drill bit, drill the pilot hole. And then I just took my screws, screwed it through the black brackets, and then on the other side in between the shell and the bracket, that's where you have your washer and your those bent pieces that I mentioned. So I'll give you a quick look right there. You can see exactly how it goes into the grill. All right, and I do have to tighten this one up a little bit more because that shouldn't be spinning like that. So I just have to tighten that screw up a little bit more. I just wanted to show you guys what we got done so far before I went any farther. So you're just going to go ahead and take these screws and those pieces and do that in every spot. You want to do, if you can, again, get the grill lined up exactly where you want it, and then just do like one hole at a time. So what I did was, what my wife and I did was, we got the grill positioned where I wanted it. I started with doing, you know, the hole over here. And then I would come to the other side of the grill, make sure this side was still lined up properly, and then I would do one on this side. Made sure it was still lined up properly everywhere, and then I would do one on the top, and then one on the bottom, and you know what I'm saying. So just kind of bounce around a little bit, and just as you're going after each hole, make sure your grill is still lined up and properly placed where you want it before you go ahead and drill your next hole and secure it with the next screw. The only other hardware they send you looks like this. So you're going to get, it's like a flat, a lock washer and a nut. And then this flat piece looks like this. It has a hole in one side. There's 6 bolts that are actually welded into the grill. You can see one right here, one here, one here, one there. And then same thing on the other side, here and here. You can see how it actually goes on. And again, this is just an extra way to make sure the grill is sandwiched in. So all you're going to do, I'll show you this one. I didn't put this one on yet. You're just going to pop it on the bolt like that. Again, the 6 bolts that are actually welded to the grill. Make sure the lip is hanging over the factory shell. And then take your lock washer, pop it on there, take your nut, screw it on there. These are 10 millimeter nuts, just so you know. I'll grab my socket, tighten that down, and again, you can see what it does. It kind of sandwiches the grill in there, making sure it's nice and secure. So let me turn the grill. I'll flip it upside down, or I'm not upside down. I'll flip it right side up, and I'll show you what we had to trim on the front of it, and where we kind of left off up there, and how it's looking, so you have an idea of how much you have to take off up there. All right, so there's a look at the front of it. I'll show you up here on top. So what I did was, when you're looking at your grill, you'll see there's a couple lips right here. I probably could have left that first lip because you can see there's a slight gap there. It's not a big deal. When you put this back on the truck and close your hood, you're never going to see that. No one's ever going to know it's there. But just to give you an idea of how it looks. And again, I can't say it enough, when you're doing your trimming and your cuts, just make sure you trim little bits at a time. You could always trim more, but once you trim too much, there's no going back. So just make your trim, your cuts nice and carefully and little bits at a time. So, all right, I'll give you a look at the sides. All in all, the fitment isn't bad. You know, it's a custom piece, it's handmade. So they're never gonna fit just like factory, but you can see the fitment is pretty good. And it did take some playing around with it. I'm not gonna lie to you. I won't lie to my viewers. It did take some toying around. You know, my wife helped me kind of get it in position and get it lined up exactly where we wanted it. But you can see the finished product with a little bit of patience and, you know, working with it a little bit. It fits just about perfectly. So we're gonna go ahead and get this thing back up in the truck and we'll show you the finished product. All right, guys, there it is back on the truck. Finished product, and I could not be happier. I love this grill, love how it came out. The quality of these grills from royaltycord.com are second to none. They are built to last. This thing is heavy duty. The finish is absolutely gorgeous. I looked it over with a fine tooth comb, not a blemish anywhere on the grill. You can tell this company really pays attention to detail. As far as the fitment goes, just be patient with it. You know, when you're making your cuts, just be real patient, take your time, don't rush it, and you can get it to basically looking just like factory. The fitment is just about perfect after a little working with it. Just a couple tips that I want to show you before, or actually now that I have the install done, before I wrap up the video, just a couple tips that I want to give you now that I have everything completed. First thing is, when you're going to fit the new grill, once you cut that middle section out of your factory grill and you're going to put the new grill in just to kind of test fit it and see what else you have to trim, just be very careful. This was my own fault, my own stupidity. I should have protected my paint a little bit better. I just have a couple small scratches. I'm hoping they'll buff out. I can't feel them, so I'm hoping they'll just buff out. If not, I'll just hit them with a little touch-up paint. They're very small, but I know they're there, so it's gonna bug me. So just be careful, protect your paint, you know, some way, somehow, as you're taking that grill in and out of there, test fitting it, and you know, before you secure it in place. The second tip, which I've already mentioned a couple times on the video, when you're cutting out your factory grill, start small. And what I mean by that is, don't cut out too much of it. You know, leave a lip. If this grill wasn't here and you're looking at your factory grill, leave a little section, a little lip, and you can always go back and trim more if you need to. You know, if you cut too much, you're out of luck. You know what I mean? This new grill is going to go right through and, you know, you're going to be stuck. So just start small and then you could always trim more as you go. All right, so royaltycord.com. Let me show you, before I forget, the TSS safety system. Let me show you what I did there. I thought I was going to have to fabricate something for this grill because it's stainless steel. I thought I was actually going to have to cut a hole somehow down here, you know, to mount that system there. Like you see other aftermarket grills have a hole right here where you can mount the system, or they make that patch that you can put right there and hide the sensor behind it. Thought I was going to have to do something like that. Well, I do not. The system, I'll show you what I did here. And this is only temporary. I just wanted to see, I mounted it, I'll get you up close. You can see the sensor right here. The area between the bottom part of the D and the top part of the frame, it is the perfect amount of space for that sensor to sit right there. And all I did was, I just wanted to see if it would shoot through the stainless steel before I went cutting the grill or anything like that. And sure enough, all I did was I took a couple zip ties and just zip tied it in place. I put them nice and snug so that sensor won't move. I took it for a ride up the highway. I took it for a ride. I was gone for 20 to 30 minutes and I had no problems whatsoever. No error messages. My adaptive cruise control works perfectly. The sensor is working perfectly, no problems whatsoever, which is a huge relief because I thought I was going to have to cut into this grill and I did not want to do that, but I also didn't want to lose my TSS capabilities. So huge relief. Now again, those zip ties are only temporary. I just wanted to do that to see if it would shoot through the stainless steel, which it is. So now I'm going to come up with some kind of mounting system to permanently mount it right there. I'm gonna color the areas that's not black on the sensor, the side pieces here, I'm gonna color them black so you can't see them behind the grill there. And I'm thrilled with that. That is a huge relief for me that I don't have to cut into this grill, and you know, I can use that TSS safety system. So just wanted to point that out. I'll keep you guys posted on what I do there for the permanent fix and the permanent mounting solution. I am going to keep it right there as far as location goes. I just have to come up with some kind of mounting system to put it right there and keep it there without them zip ties. Now, I'm not going to lie, the zip ties, you could barely even see them because they are basically the same size as the wire from the mesh, and of course they're black, so you can't even really see them. But there's no way I'm putting zip ties on a grill that beautiful, and yeah, that's just not gonna fly. So I will keep you guys posted and updated on what I decide to do there. So as always, guys, I appreciate you watching. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, leave them down below. Be sure to check out royaltycore.com. Tell them I sent you, if you don't mind, and we'll see you guys on the next video. Thanks a lot for watching. Take care.